Hi there, I am here with Michael Janosky, who is one of our studio artists at Nickel Plate Arts. Mike, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, certainly. As you said, I'm a studio artist here at Nickel Plate Arts, upstairs in the Judge Stone building. I have been here for over 8 years, so when Nickel Plate opened, I moved in. So I'm a long timer here, and I love my studio space, and love being involved in the arts community here in Noblesville. And in Hamilton County. So in my studio, you can see I have many paintings available for your shopping for the holiday season. I did complete a Dunes residency. I was a resident artist at the Indiana Dunes National Park in the fall of 2018 and the spring of 2019. I have a lot of pieces from that residency. I created a substantial body of work. I have a lot of people come into the studio that have a connection with the dunes and like to see that. I also have several local pieces, Midwest, Noblesville, the surrounding area, some of the state parks in the area, so a wide range of things available. Most of the work in my studio that's available for purchase is original oil paintings. I do have a few reproductions that are available as well, some limited edition prints, some open edition prints, and some signed note cards.
Great. Where are some of the places that people can purchase your items, whether it's a store around the area or a website, or go ahead?
Yeah, certainly. So in addition to my studio, where you can buy directly through me, or if I'm not available during Nickel Plate's regular business hours, the staff can help you with transactions. I am also part of the gifted show that Nickel Plate Arts has coming up for the holiday season. So downstairs in this building, in our main gallery, I'll have some winter and holiday themed pieces. I also have work available at Noble Made in downtown Noblesville and in Carmel at the Indiana Artisan Store on Rangeline Road in Carmel. So that's locally the easiest places to see my work. I have things in a few exhibits in other places in Indiana right now. One is fairly close for the moment in Indianapolis at the Indiana State Museum. I have a piece that was juried into the Indiana Plein Air Painters Association show, which is a partnership with the DNR, and it's highlighting 60 different historic spots in Indiana. And one of my residency paintings of the Century of Progress houses was accepted into that. So one of the houses, there's a different view, is a Florida tropical house, the pink house that's in Beverly Shores. So my painting at the State Museum shows that house and the house next to it, and shows the effect that erosion on the shoreline has had in that area. So that will be here through this month, and then it starts traveling through the state for the next year. I believe up next it will be in Fort Wayne. I also have two pieces that were juried into the Richmond Annual Exhibition of Indiana and Ohio Artists this year. And that again is in Richmond, Indiana at their art museum. And I believe that show runs into early January.
Great. So in addition to stopping by to see your artwork in your studio, which is upstairs at Nickel Plate Arts, people can find stuff locally at Noble Made. Downstairs at Nickel Plate Arts as part of our gifted exhibit in Carmel. And what about, do you do any commissions, Mike?
I'm certainly open to doing commissions. If you have a certain subject that you are partial to that I've not painted, you can certainly discuss me painting that for you. Rates are the same as what my paintings go for in the studio. So if you look at my prices, I don't charge a premium for commissions. As long as I have a good photograph to work from, or I can visit the site and actually work with you to get a good view of that scene, we should be able to come with a subject and design you'd be happy with.
Cool. So we can see your originals here on the wall. Why don't we go over here and talk about your prints?
So I use a local copy shop that can scan my original paintings and come up with a good quality image. And then they can do prints for me. I have two different types of prints that are available. One is what you call an open edition print. That means that I could make as many of these as I wanted to. Then I also do some limited edition prints that have a very low print run, which are over here in a different print bin so as to not confuse them. All my prints you can see are signed with the title. The limited editions are numbered, so this is the first out of a series of 25 prints, and then they're all hand signed.
Very cool. So then you see number two.
Right.
And so on with this piece.
Yeah, so I think I just have the first few out of several of these.
Okay, oh, that's nice.
Yeah, lots of different subjects. Nice.
Skip to number one. Mm-hmm. All right, there's another scene there. Great, so these are the limited edition prints, which I think these would look great on anyone's wall, especially if they have a love of kind of waterfronts or a love of the dunes area.
Right. And if somebody is interested in something I have not done as a limited edition print, as long as I have not done it as an open edition print yet, I could do that for other pieces. I don't necessarily paint a piece and think that I want to make prints of it. Some pieces I think just lend themselves to prints, so I'm very selective about what I do.
Very cool. So we've got some options, whether, depending on if people are looking for art for themselves this holiday season or buying for someone else, they can buy an original work, an open edition print, or a limited edition print. And so there are definitely some options and some different price points.
Exactly. And I do accept exchanges. So if you purchase something for somebody and it doesn't quite fit their decor, they could switch it out for another item of the same price. I could also switch out a frame if the frame style didn't work with what they would like to have, but they like the painting itself. I work a lot with the darker frames. I also use gold frames and some silver frames as well. Those seem to be the three most popular framing styles right now. But that's something that we can work with to suit your decor and your taste.
Great. Well, this has been Michael Janosky and the Nickel Plate Arts, his upstairs studio. Where can they go to find you online, Mike?
Okay. I do have a website, michaeljanoskystudio.com. And you can also find me on Facebook. I have a personal page that I'm sure you could see, as well as a business page, Michael Janosky Studio.
Great. We'll put that on the screen and let people know about it. Thanks for showing us around and telling us about your artwork.
Yeah, certainly. And if you are interested in making any purchases or just visiting for the season, if you'd like to make sure I'm here, shoot me a text. You can find all that contact information on my website and on my Facebook page. I'd be happy to meet you here.
Great. All right. Thanks a lot, Mike.
Thank you.